Breaks. It's Thursday, March 7th, 2024. Coming up on the program today, ladyboys versus trans prostitutes street brawl. Plus, it's time to bowl out with your hole out. Naked bowling comes to Pittsburgh. And the cuckoo crazy banana science of cloud busting. Make those clues disappear. Distorted View Daily proudly presents Great Moments in Phone Sex Introduction Messages.
You see, I may look like a not so classy fucking bitch, but underneath I'm nothing but a fucking little whore. My mama, oh, she didn't care whether I whored myself out or not, but I did. And my daddy, he was my best fucking customer. He fucking taught me how to suck that dick. And I became nothing but a little nigger whore. Well, you see my little brand fucking pussy? And my sweet little honey box of an ass? Motherfuckers, them white boys, they love that fucking little brown little sugar box of mine. And you know you've been dying to fucking try it. Cause once you go black, you never go back, as they say. Oh, I know that's an old adage, but oh, baby. I'm so fucking hot tonight. My nipples are standing straight up. And my pussy. Oh, I got that black thong on, pulling up between my pussy lips right now. Oh, right now it's just, oh, making my pussy. Oh, won't you come and fuck this little black bitch? Oh, let me wrap those titties of mine right around that big old white cock of yours. Come be my man. Come make me cream. Oh, I'll make you explode.
It's the Distorted View Show with Tim Henson.
Christian now fears his flatulence.
Is Miss Vagina thinking about Mr. Penis?
The guy, he's in the dirty underwear or something. I don't know. He's sniff freak.
A lot of hot liquid poo just went out all at once.
Yes, Tim Henson back here with you for the Thursday episode of DB. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a great one. Longtime listeners of the show know one of my favorite finds over the years has been T. Chase, a psychic who can control clouds. Now, when I say control clouds, I mean that he can make them disappear. So he says, he's got a bunch of these videos on his YouTube channel. Here is his most recent.
Hey, it's another cloud control video by T. Chase. This is where I try to control clouds with my psychic powers. As I do this, I have to kind of chant to focus the psychic energy.
And this is why I happen to love T. Chase. The chanting. It's so good. Now, I don't know if you've ever stared at clouds up in the sky for a while, but they move and they change shapes on their own. Small ones will disappear. You know, clouds don't exist forever. They go away, right? So in reality, he's doing absolutely nothing aside from chanting like an idiot.
See this small cloud? I'll focus on this one. I'm going to try to just make this small cloud disappear using psychic powers. Cloud disappear. Cloud disappear.
Right.
Try to make the small cloud disappear.
Yeah, we got it. We know what you're trying to do.
Cloud disappear.
For some reason, you got to say it like that. Cloud.
Blue sky. Cloud disappear. Cloud disappear.
So good, right?
Disappear.
Now, as I stated, this is his most recent cloud psychokinesis video, but that was recorded back in October 2021. He hasn't done one of these in a while, a couple years.
Cloud disappear.
To be fair, all of the cloud videos kind of sound the same. Cloud. A lot of this.
Blue sky.
And while the cloud does kind of disappear, it's clear it's due to nature and not the psychic powers of this fruitcake.
Cloud disappear.
Well, I was blown away to learn T. Chase isn't the only cloud manipulator out there. Thanks to DB listener and Discord user GRV, today I learned about cloud busting. They provided a link to a Twitter video that had absolutely no sound and left me with more questions than anything. The tweet reads, "Fascinated with these Organite Cloudbusters." And then there's a video of this guy pointing a device at clouds, making the cloud disappear. Apparently, cloud busting is not a new idea. As a matter of fact, there's a Wikipedia entry for cloudbusters. A cloudbuster is a device designed by Austrian psychoanalyst Wilhelm Reich, which he claimed could produce rain by manipulating what he called orgone energy present in the atmosphere. You may be wondering what the fuck orgone energy is, as was I. Apparently, orgone energy was an idea proposed by Wilhelm Reich as well. The idea is it's some sort of living energy, a hypothetical universal life force. It's bullshit. There is no empirical support for the concept of orgone in medicine or the physical sciences. Because of that, and the fact we're living in the weirdest of times, there's now been an uptick in believers of orgone energy, and the chemtrail conspiracy theory movement has adopted the belief. They're all in on this mythical fairy dust up in the clouds. So in the Twitter video that I was just talking about, the very first reply from Jose reads, "What do you get out of busting a cloud? Did you get energy? What are the benefits of doing this? I'm really curious." Good question, Jose. The man who filmed the video, and I guess was busting the cloud, replied, "I just want more bluer skies." That's why you're killing the clouds? That's not a good reason. This guy's like Marvin the Martian from those old Warner Brothers cartoons. He was on the moon trying to blow up the Earth because it obstructed his view of Venus. How is this any different? The sky isn't as pretty when it's littered with this white garbage. All right, so he says, "I just want more bluer skies." This is a grammatical nightmare. Also, he spells sky S-K-Y-E. He goes on, "For whatever reason, a lot of the skies around the world are dirty and smoggy, whether that's chemtrails, pollution, EMFs. There's a variety of reasons there. So they need a helping hand clearing up. More sun, more beautiful skies, and nice puffy white clouds." Yeah, only cumulus clouds are allowed in this guy's hood. If you're fluffy and bulbous, you can stay. If you're thin and wispy, we don't want you. Reminds me of shit streaks in the underpants of someone who don't wipe so good. No crappy clouds on my watch, thank you. There was a community note written about this guy's video. "This is a heavily sped up video, and the clouds are likely moving naturally. Orgone therapy is seen as a pseudoscience." I turned to YouTube, and of course, there was a bunch of cloud busting videos, including people making their own cloud busting tools.
All right, I'm going to record a new cloud buster video. Oh. This is one that I haven't...
You can hear in the background, this guy has procreated. This does not bode well for mankind. But yes, I'm sorry. Go on, sir.
This is one that I haven't completed yet. It's going to be one of the powered cloud busters that I do.
I noticed there wasn't an update to this video, so I'm guessing he electrocuted himself to death. Apparently, even without it being powered, it still has the ability to make clouds disappear.
I haven't done yet, but all the scalar waves are intact and they should be working. See here, just do a quick demonstration.
I notice he focuses in on the smallest possible clouds in the sky. Also, even before he starts zapping the clouds, they're starting to shrink on their own. Get
that little guy right there, and hopefully he'll go real quick.
It's already mostly gone.
I'm gonna do the whole chain. There's three little clouds there. I'm gonna get this one, and then I'll move up.
Oh, I hope chanting is involved.
I haven't done a Cloudbuster video in a while, but so I'm going to do another one real Daddy. Quick. This is...
Daddy!
The first
Daddy.
One's gone. The second one gone.
Pay attention to me! You're always in your garage making ghost-busting equipment and cloud killers. You're a fucking loser, Daddy.
Look at those guys. Look at all those roly-polies.
Yeah, look
They're
at
They're everywhere.
That. They all must die!
So that's...
These people just absolutely hate clouds.
That's those three. A little bit left of the second two, but it's probably going to be hard to see on video anyway.
So you didn't make the clouds disappear then? He has several videos, and it's so funny because, you know, YouTube lets you speed up the playback to like 2 times the speed. And if you watch these, you can see all of the other clouds are changing shape and slowly fading away on their edges and stuff. Like, clouds, that's what clouds do, right? But when this guy talks, he's like, the only cloud that is changing shape here is the one I'm pointing my device at.
You'll notice none of the other clouds are really changing at all. Just that one's going.
So when he said that, I totally focused on one of the smaller clouds on the edge of the screen. One that, you know, he's not really paying any attention to. And of course, it disappears on its own as well.
That one's going. So it's very focused. This is a healing device for your home more than for what I'm doing now. This is just a demonstration. It's just an easy way to show you the proof of the energy that's being emitted.
It's so powerful. It has the ability to manipulate water vapor. Ooh. I know you guys are all wondering, how do I make a cloud buster of my own? For that, we need to turn to another YouTuber. This is Sensei Dennis.
This is how to build a cloud buster. Things that you will need. First, 4 10-foot links of 1-inch copper pipe.
Oh my God, those are so expensive though. Copper? Good God.
If copper isn't available, steel or aluminum is just fine.
Oh, okay, you can basically just use anything. If you don't have access to steel or aluminum, cardboard paper towel tubes will work in a pinch. I already have a lot of confidence in this project. Sensei Dennis goes on to instruct that we have to cut the tubes into various lengths. I'm not going to bore you with that.
You'll need 6 end caps to go on the bottom. You'll need 6 double terminated crystals to go in the end caps.
Okay, this is starting to sound less like engineering a sophisticated weather manipulation tool and a lot more like New Age magic. What type of crystals can we use?
You'll need 6 3/4 to 1-inch piece of garden hose.
I'm sorry, I have more questions about this crystal. I did a search for double terminated quartz. According to the Crystal Digest, which reminds me I need to renew my subscription ASAP. Don't want that running out. Double terminated quartzes can help to amplify energy as well as protect the individual from negative energy, like evil clouds. The double terminated quartz is a must-have for any crystal collection. Great for meditation and grounding. All right, check this shit out. Go on eBay and do a search for Orgon, O-R-G-O-N-E, and also cloud. You'll be blown away. So many people selling these scam devices, including my favorite, the super powerful 6-shooter Cloudbuster. Complete Chembuster Orgon Energy. It's a 6-foot Cloudbuster / Chembuster. Transform your environment positively. Organize yourself. Place the unit on the ground outside or inside and watch chemtrails disappear while bringing in the good vibrations. Orgon utilizes scalar wave technology to harmonize the zero-point energy field. Like, none of those words mean anything. This is all bullshit. Orgon uses scalar wave technology to harmonize the zero-point energy field, which is all-pervasive in the environment to bring peace and tranquility. And you can have your very own super-powerful 6-shooter Cloudbuster for the low price of $1,100. 3 are currently available. And the shocking thing is 14 have already been sold. This guy has raked in over $15,000 selling Cloudbusters on eBay. And that's just this one listing. I am in the wrong business. Well, there you go. It's not just T. Chase trying to make the clouds disappear anymore. There are many, many Cloudbusters out there. All right, moving on now. Haley's Comet sent along a very satisfying link. We play a lot of clips of irritating streamers who just annoy and antagonize people. And many times, the streamers get away with these shitty antics. Now, this is one of those times where the streamer kind of gets what she deserves. She's a racist piece of shit, as you'll be able to tell from the language she uses in the video. I'm not sure if she's drunk. Maybe that's probably her best defense, but I'm not sure if she is inebriated, but she's outside of a bar throwing bottles at black people. Let's see how that works out for her.
She's not throwing a bottle at you.
But there's actually ways.
Yeah, I'll fucking throw another bottle, bitch. Yeah, you're right, you're mad. I'll fucking throw another bottle, bitch.
I think she is drunk. I mean, she's having trouble forming words.
You're in that bed, bitch. Y'all wanna find another bed, bitch.
Maybe she's having a stroke, which is great timing because today is Thursday. Happy birthday, Shin. I don't know what you're saying. Happy birthday, Shin. A shabba shabba sinky Shin. Happy birthday, Shin. I don't know what you're saying. It's happy birthday, Shin Thursday.
Come on.
Bitch, throw another motherfucking can. I'm gonna beat your motherfucking.
No!
It should be noted at this point, no one has laid a hand on her. That was like a preemptive scream as she's running away. So as far as I can tell, what happened was she threw a bottle. Then she started to walk away from the scene. Then she turns around, heads back. They always head back. Throws another bottle or can. That's, of course, when this happened.
Bitch, throw another motherfucking can. I'm gonna beat your motherfucking.
No!
She once again flees.
Yo, guess what? I didn't even throw it at your head, nigger.
There's that language I was mentioning. That's certainly not a heavy birtation right there. She knew what she was saying.
Throw another motherfucking chair, bitch.
And again, she heads back to confront these people again. Maybe throw another bottle.
I'm not playing with you.
I'm going to throw another one in there.
Yeah.
Promise?
Good idea. Yes, that laughter quickly turned to pain. I gotta hear that again. And this is when the consequences for her actions catch up to her. This is one of the most satisfying cries I've heard in a long time.
I don't give a fuck.
Well, you know what?
You have to listen closely, but her friend there is screaming at the black people saying, "You assaulted her! That's assault!"
I don't give a fuck.
No, that's payback, bitch.
Well, you know what?
I mean, this crying goes on for a while, and I could listen to every second of it. I don't know if you guys get off to it as hard as I do, so I'll just fast forward a bit.
Her face is bleeding. This is actual assault. Security guard. Your face is bleeding, goo.
So the girl who is bleeding, who's crying there, is just like, I just want to go. Because I think she knows she's going to get in trouble, too. She started this, really, throwing cans and bottles at people. That's assault. I just want to go.
Face is bleeding goo, and they don't believe it.
I want to go.
Look at that. Carlos, her nose is busted. Come here. She has a bleeding face. Because of that woman.
Oh, I noticed you didn't call her an N-word this time. Now she's a lady.
Because that is complete assault, right?
It's funny, like, no one is coming over to help. I don't know if it's security guards that have been called over, other patrons. Not a lot of sympathy for this girl. Yeah, hate to see it. Speaking of racist pieces of shit, Nick Fuentes was recently streaming. I guess he was reacting to Super Tuesday news as it came in, of course. Super Tuesday here in America is where there's a bunch of primaries, right, for the presidency. Nick, who a lot of people think is gay, but very repressed. I don't think this most recent live stream is going to help dispel any of those rumors. Now he's just like hard. Well, we knew he was always hard for Trump, but like he keeps talking about how hot Trump is.
You know what's awesome about Trump is he's like 80 years old almost, but he looks fucking hot.
Are you sure that's the word you meant to use? You could have just went with like youthful. He doesn't look like an old man. You chose hot. Trump is hot.
All these other 80-year-old guys, all these other 80-year-old white guys beating look like him. This. Have you ever realized? A lot of people make fun of Trump for his look, but John McCain was like the same age and he looked like a dork.
I would not put my dick in that. Now, Trump, now that's a man I can bang.
And Trump just looks like a beast. So people say, oh, you're orange. Your hair's stupid. He looks fucking awesome. He looks hot.
Doubling down on hot.
So you could either look like this when you're 70, just look like another boring white guy, just look like a lame old cracker. Or you could look like this Aryan Chad, Hitler-esque, Caesar-esque.
He's saying a lot of words there.
Mussolini mold.
Hot, Hitler-esque, Aryan. Boy, Nick is saying all the right things here.
Moment, Napoleon, men who will define epochs. Liberals are like, you know, this retard is like, well, the Trump voters are super loyal because last week they said Biden was too old, but Biden's the same age and 100% of them say that he's fit to. It's like, yes, we embrace the contradiction because we die for the man, Donald Trump, because we die for the personhood of Donald Trump and what he represents.
It's all very perfectly normal. Nothing to see here.
Trump gives the order, we follow. It's as simple as that. You can never understand.
I guess while we're playing just crazy unhinged clips today, we might as well move on with an ex-girlfriend confrontation. Actually, this guy's just minding his own business in his car. His crazy ex, who has been stalking him, sees an opportunity for a little one-on-one chat. And so she runs and enters his vehicle. And that's when this takes place.
So, for the record...
Stop!
I'm telling you, you can get out. I'm asking you, please get
out. And I'm asking you to fucking listen!
Her entire hoodie is a Confederate flag pattern. Like, it's not just, like, a Confederate flag in the center of the hoodie. The whole thing is a Confederate flag. That's a red flag.
I'm telling you, you can get out. I'm asking you, please get
and
out.
And I'm asking you to fucking listen!
Please get out of my pickup.
Just fucking listen to me for once in your life.
Please get out of my pickup.
You want me to key this fucking thing? Because I fucking will if you don't listen.
Cool. Okay, well, she opens the door to get out and then threatens to key the car.
Because I fucking will.
We're making progress.
Don't listen.
Cool. Shut my door and leave me. Just shut my door.
Stop recording me. Stop.
No, this is my pickup. It's all on record. You want to key my truck? Great. I'll come after you for the insurance.
I don't give a fuck. Just fucking listen.
No, go. Close
my
door.
Put the fucking phone down. Put the fucking phone down. Stop recording and fucking listen.
Shut my door.
Not until you stop recording me.
Shut my door.
Now you can't be recording me because I've told you to stop. You're doing it illegally, so I suggest you stop. Yeah, you are, because I said stop.
Wait, you're in his car. Although you're not even in the car anymore. You're just out in public. Okay, whatever.
Ross won public property.
I said stop.
Boy, this bitch is really upset. She's no longer in control of him.
Ross won public property.
He does not call the shots.
I said stop.
Looks like the South is about to lose again.
Ross won public property.
I said stop.
It's a public school.
Andrew, stop recording me!
Shut my truck door.
Not until you stop recording me.
Shut my truck door and
stop recording me, and I fucking will.
You can't force your way through this one. You can't scream your way through it.
You just not gonna do you. You need to stop being an immature bitch and listen.
That argument would have seemed probably a little more valid if you didn't just threaten to key his car, refuse to get out of it.
Yeah, you are. You're fucking being immature. No, you're not. You being nice would be you listening. Don't fucking.
Oh. Rude.
Thank you.
She does finally leave, but I don't think he's seen the last of her. Peppered in the comments is like more information from the person who posted this video. This couple apparently broke up a while ago. She's been stalking him. At one point, while they were dating, she pretended she was pregnant to keep him. That didn't work out so well. On the night of this incident, she tried pressuring him into letting her give him a blowjob. She jumped into his truck without his permission and had been stalking him since they broke up. Oh, there's also video of her on the subreddit Fake Disorder Cringe. Oh, no. She was one of those assholes. In the video, she's seen collapsing, just falling to the ground. She claims to have POTS, P-O-T-S, which I guess is a disorder that makes you lightheaded and fall and faint or whatever. She also claims to have DID because everyone has multiple personalities in 2024. If you're on TikTok and you don't have multiple personalities, I've got news for you. You also don't have followers. You can't really call yourself an influencer without a system. couple other real short clips. I found this one funny. I don't know. It's nighttime. A train is stopped on the train tracks, and someone is very upset with the train for stopping where it stopped.
15 minutes ago. Yep, just got home 15 minutes ago. Look who it is. Mr. fucking piece of shit in 4091.
That's the number of the train.
The 8 p.m. pervert. No fucking reason for him to be stopping here except to harass people. And look at how he's parked. Parked just so where he's blocking the sidewalk and blocking the street. Can't get around because of this piece of shit right here.
This is a real train, like a choo-choo train. This guy is taking it very personally, isn't he?
Yep, this punk-ass little bitch sitting in his fucking train. Too much of a fucking pussy to get out and fucking do anything, aren't ya?
Like, he wants to fight the conductor or engineer, whoever's driving this train.
Punk-ass little bitch. 4091. I guess you can talk to the fucking PAD officer again, you piece of shit.
I love at the beginning of the video, he refers to this train driver as the 8 p.m. pervert. Like, this happens on a regular basis. The train comes, like, slowly creeping up, stops right in front of a playground. You just see this guy in the window, like, leering at the kids. Here's the thing, freaks. I found this guy's YouTube channel, and it's just hundreds and hundreds of videos just like the one I played for you. He really dislikes trains. I think the issue is he lives next to a train station or very close to train tracks, and it's driving him slowly insane.
Yep, 8:30.
Here's another video, this time at 8:30. The 8 p.m. pervert's there, probably.
Sunday night. Guess who's sitting out here right outside my fucking front door? Made it a fucking point to stop right in front of my fucking house again.
Doing it on purpose.
This piece of shit, this punk bitch, 4091 right there.
It's always the same one.
Fucking worthless motherfucker who's stalking me every fucking night. Here he is once again.
That is kind of scary to have a train following you around.
Acting like the little fucking punk bitch that he is. Yeah, talking about you in the fucking train, bitch.
These videos are very recent. Like, it happened this month, you know, March 2024. Here's another one. This one actually takes place during the day.
It's now 12:30. Here's Mr. Shitbag in 5735 still harassing my entire goddamn neighborhood with a fucking train.
So then the train starts to back up, and that just gets him riled up even more.
Now let's take a moment to go to my bathroom window, because I'm sure the piece of shit is going to stop outside my bathroom window. He's only done that about 3 times already.
By the way, someone on YouTube created the account Union Pacific Customer Support just to leave comments on his videos, including, "We're always watching you, Sean."
The 8 p.m. pervert, right on fucking time. Evidently, they got this piece of shit working weekends as a punishment for peeping into people's windows in the middle of the night.
Why would they give him the night shift then, Sean? He's just gonna go peeping into more windows.
Same fat, bearded piece of shit. And when I say that these people are fucking shitbags, they really are. Fat, bearded, creepy as fuck. They've looked me up.
I'm oddly now invested in this guy's life. Like, this guy, his house is literally like 2 doors down from the train tracks. It wasn't a wise purchase if locomotive noise bothers you. Sean here also filmed when the police paid him a visit. Oh, of course he's had some police interactions.
I'm here because you were calling the UPS about 15 times complaining about the train.
I asked for a supervisor 15 times and they kept hanging up on me. They kept transferring me to another email service.
Yeah, because you're complaining about a train that's driving.
He does this every... No, he's not driving through. He's sitting right here.
Tell him about how he's looking into your bathroom window.
Yeah, I mean, It's a train, so there's going to be numerous cars that are attached to the train, right?
It doesn't matter if the train is 3 blocks long or 2 miles long. He's always sitting out here behind, right there, just to where he's blocking the sidewalk and the street. He does it every single night.
So, yeah, the real reason why the cops are there, of course, is because Sean keeps calling Union Pacific. The cops just want him to stop doing that.
Because you are calling them over and over again.
I'm not making any threats. I'm not calling them any names. I'm not doing anything. I'm simply calling them trying to make a complaint.
15 times.
I'm trying to call and make a complaint with them. 15 times. And they are ignoring my complaint. 15
times. I don't know if this is I doubt this is the first time the cops have interacted with Sean, but they have to know they're not going to get anywhere with him.
Train is 3 blocks long.
It's an issue for you.
Why can't they back up 2 blocks?
I would recommend that you move, and so you don't have to deal with this.
No, that's not the solution. This is intolerable. Who's your supervisor? I want to speak to your supervisor, your watch commander.
He doesn't come out for something like this.
Yeah. Why did you come out here for something like this?
Because the Union Pacific called us that you called them over 15 times.
They have their own police department. Don't they have federal jurisdiction? Every time I call you guys about this, you tell me you can't do anything about it.
Because
they got federal jurisdiction.
My absolute favorite part of this video is, you know, this police visit lasts so long, right? It's getting darker and darker. And then you start to hear a train in the background. And Sean loses his goddamn mind.
Yes. That is stupid.
Calling and complaining.
That is stupid.
Here comes the train.
Yeah. So, you see that? Honking right there?
Yeah.
Because he has to.
He's notifying people that could potentially be driving.
They do that in
You clearly have no idea what you're doing.
You're blind.
Blind.
No.
Blind. That in every intersection.
I know they do that at every intersection, yeah. But he doesn't do
That's their job. That's their job.
This is not harassment. I agree with you on that. This is not harassment. When he's sitting out here right in front of my house every single night for 2 goddamn weeks straight.
Well, I've subscribed to this YouTube channel because I got to see where this all goes. It's not going to end well for Sean.
Yep. Little fucking bitch right here.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, go fuck yourself, asshole. You know where to find me. You want to come out of that fucking train.
Yeah, I saw those numbers on the side of the train. The 8 p.m. pervert's back.
Fucking punk-ass piece of shit. Fat little fucking bitch sitting in a fucking train. That's who's stalking me. Some fucking waste of life piece of shit.
Just a bit of an introduction to the ongoing saga of Sean and the train. And with that, let's get into the crazy bizarre twist and fucked up news right now. If you enjoy Distorted View Daily, please consider supporting this nonsense. Become a member of The Sideshow, where every week you'll be receiving 5 episodes of Distorted View Daily, including 3 Sideshow exclusive ones that makes this very podcast a daily show. Memberships are very inexpensive, only $6.99 a month, even less when you opt for a quarterly, semi-annual, yearly, or lifetime membership. Check out superfreaksideshow.com. When you sign up, you get access to a personalized RSS feed. You'll have like a username and password. It works with most podcasting apps like Apple Podcasts, Overcast, Pocket Casts, Podcast Addict. Works with most of the big podcasting apps. Now, for an even easier way to sign up, if you happen to use Apple Podcasts or Spotify to get your shows, you can sign up right inside those apps. Just a few taps, you'll gain access. You'll see the Sideshow exclusive episodes right alongside the free episodes of the show, which is very cool. For more information, check out distortedview.com and, of course, superfreaksideshow.com. One final way to help support the show, we've got a Patreon account. Patreon.com/distortedview. If you pledge at least $5, you get access to a special voicemail line where I will play your calls first. And we have some higher tiers as well. If you pledge $20, occasionally I send out DV merchandise, little gifts, right? Coming in March, we've got a Distorted View logo plushy pillows, which I told you guys I was going to show you a picture on the show notes, and I forgot to do that. So I'll try to remember today to include that. I think they're very cool. So again, patreon.com/distortedview. Okay, 3 very quick stories now. First up, violence erupted and blood was shed in Thailand recently after a vicious clash broke out between Filipino transgender prostitutes and their sworn enemies, Thai ladyboys. It was a bitch fight to the death. Yes, in reality, I'm not making any of this up. It was Filipino transgender prostitutes fighting Thai ladyboys over territorial disputes in Bangkok's notorious red light district. The altercation took place on Monday night when over 100 local sex workers confronted a group of Filipino sex workers operating from the Sitin Sukhumvit, some hotel. Apparently, this location is renowned for its go-go bars, street workers, and massage parlors. It's ground zero for Lady Dick Nookie Nookie. The conflict ignited when the first Filipino sex worker was forcefully removed from the hotel, accused of engaging in a previous altercation with the locals and poaching their clients. Have you no sense of honor, ma'am? You're breaking the ladyboy code of conduct. Anyway, the situation rapidly deteriorated as the local ladyboys... I'm sorry. As the local ladyboys, incensed by the presence of their rivals, unleashed a chaotic brawl. Video footage captured the intense melee. With flying stilettos, local transgender women attacking police officers, climbing structures, stomping on opponents, hurling objects, and even experiencing wardrobe malfunctions. Some nip slips and vag lips. Poking through. Sounds like my kind of scene, man. The commotion reportedly spilled over to the nearby Lumpini District Police Station, where the Filipino transgender women were taken into custody for allegedly working without the appropriate visas and permits. A police colonel stated that the police were promptly deployed to the scene to maintain order and prevent further violence. He assured that all parties involved would be treated fairly and that investigations would continue to identify and interrogate additional suspects. The police also plan to verify the immigration status of the individuals to ascertain their eligibility to even work in Thailand. Bangkok's red light districts have been a magnet for sex workers and tourists since the 1960s, following the establishment of entertainment venues by American troops stationed in Thailand. I knew America had to have something to do with this. It's got our stink all over the situation. Did you guys know that in Thailand, prostitution is technically illegal? Everyone just sort of like looks the other way, including the police departments. Law enforcement is just like, I didn't see anything as long as you pay us off and maybe suck us off too. The industry attracts sex workers from across the globe to cater to the demands of pleasure-seeking tourists. Well, if you're an ambitious whore, you might think about relocating to Bangkok, you know, for the glitz and the glamour. All right, second story we have for you today. In Las Vegas, a visitor from California experienced a shocking ordeal while staying at a strip resort. That's the Las Vegas Strip. He wasn't staying at a strip club. This all happened during the holiday season. Michael Farchi of Agora Hills reported being stung by a scorpion on his testicles while sleeping. Wow. That incident obviously left him in severe pain, and now he's considering legal action. Farchi recounted waking up to an intense stabbing sensation in his private areas. Upon inspecting the cause of the pain, he discovered a scorpion still attached to his underwear. Oh, I would be freaking the fuck out. The painful encounter occurred on December 26th. Maybe that's the baby Jesus's way of saying, hey, you shouldn't be celebrating my holy birthday in the land of sin. Anyway, this prompted Farchi and his family to check out of the hotel a day earlier than planned. In response, the resort comped his room, which was nice. I feel like they could have done a little more for him. Maybe some coupons for a buffet or tickets to the Blue Man Group show. A little something to emotionally ease the pain. Photos shared by Farchi and his attorney showed the orange scorpion responsible for the sting. Farchi admitted to not knowing how the scorpion entered his room, stating he found it under his bed covers. I thought it was in his underwear. Sounds like this guy can't keep his story straight. Dude, I don't think you should be suing anyone. You're going to completely fall apart on the witness stand. Farchi said, it felt like somebody stabbing me in the private area. It felt like a sharp glass, or a knife. He went to the restroom and saw the scorpion hanging on his underwear. All right. But then later on in the article, he says, I don't even know how it got in the room. It was under my covers. Your Honor, I'm requesting you dismiss this case. Barchi filed a report with the Venetian Resort Las Vegas, where he was staying, detailing that he was bitten on his groin and testicle at around 8 a.m. He reported being in significant pain and held the resort responsible for the incident. Following the sting, Barchi sought medical attention at a local hospital, where he was diagnosed with a scorpion sting. The event left everyone, including Barchi, in disbelief. He has an incident number from the resort and is contemplating legal action with the assistance of his attorney, Brian Vierig. Vierig highlighted the trauma caused by the scorpion sting and emphasized the importance of the resort having and adhering to proper procedures to prevent such incidents. In response to inquiries, the Venetian stated that the resort has protocols for handling incidents and confirmed that those were followed in Farchi's case. Farchi's lawyer advises that guests should always inspect their hotel rooms and surrounding areas upon check-in to avoid similar unpleasant experiences. Now we gotta be on the lookout for fucking scorpions. You know, traveling and vacation just seems like a giant headache. It's more trouble than it's worth. I think I'm just gonna stay home, thank you. Never once had a scorpion attack my nutsack here. All right, final story we have for you. I have got some great fun news for those of you living in Pittsburgh. What are you doing on Sunday, April 28th? Oh, you haven't made any plans yet? Well, you've got plans now. Balls Out Bowling is back for, quote, the ultimate bowling experience. And by that, they mean bowling with your
dick and nuts
out. And you thought getting your testicles pinched by a scorpion hurts. Wait until your friend throws a 13-pound bowling ball at your crotch. I'm sure there's going to be at least a few injuries reported, and maybe even a few assaults. This event is being put on by the Pittsburgh Area Naturalists, and apparently it's not their first time with these ball-out bowling events. By the way, women are allowed to go nude bowling as well, and they don't even have to be fully nude, which is bullshit, in my opinion. If guys they have to be completely nude from head to toe. Women, though, can just be topless. They're allowed to wear pants. The fuck is up with that? What happened to equality? The event obviously is for those over the age of 18. You don't have to be a pro bowler. You can be an amateur, but please be attractive. If you're a 5 or under, keep your clothes on and maybe go to mini golf or something that day. I don't know. You're just going to see a lot of people like bending over, picking up those heavy balls. We don't want to see ugly people. It's bad enough everyone's going to have to be wearing those awful shoes to make people look goofy. They're completely naked except for the bowling shoes. Okay. Sexual activity is not permitted at the event. The mere fact they had to state that means that there were some issues last year. According to WTRF, the local news affiliate that ran this story, the event organizers say nudism does not equal consent. Harassment will not be taken lightly. Violators will be asked to leave. And by the way, you can't take photos or video. No cell phones allowed. If you live in Pittsburgh and you're interested, tickets are only $25. Not a bad deal. You could buy them through Eventbrite. And according to the Balls Out Naked Bowling Facebook page, this will be an unforgettable night of bowling, music, and good times. Most people in the comments seem like they're excited about the event, although a guy named David is kind of pissed off. So women have the option of wearing bottoms and covering up the vagina. I had to come right out and say that. But men have to be naked? No thanks. I'll just stick to the nude bar where the women are naked and I am clothed. So y'all know where David will be on April 28th. All right, there you go. That, my friends, is your distorted news for Thursday. Let's do a couple voicemails and get the hell out of here. All right, guys, love to hear from you. And there are many ways to contact the show. show@distortedview.com. I'm all over social media at distortedview on Twitter and Instagram. Don't forget, we've got that new post office box. I'm going to check my box today, as a matter of fact. Thank you to everyone who continues to send crap to me. Really appreciate it. Remember, if you pledge $5 or more to our Patreon account, you get access to a special voicemail line where I will play your calls first. And yes, we've got some patrons checking in, so we'll play a few of those calls and then a few maybe regular voicemails, and then we'll wrap things up here.
Hi, Jim. It's Autistic Mexican.
Hey, it's been a few days. Where have you been?
I now have you assigned a speed dial number 5.
Oh.
In the Honda Odyssey of Sadness.
Oh, that is so sad I'm on your speed dial.
So I made my own Discord server because I'm planning on starting my own podcast in the near future.
I think you got the order of all that mixed up. Aren't you supposed to start the podcast first so you get people listening who want to go into a Discord you've created for the show? Call me crazy, but that seems more reasonable. Also, this is just a great time to start a podcast. 20 years into the medium, after every fucking famous celebrity in the world has started their own podcast, and all of the advertising money is drying up in podcasting, now you've decided to jump in. This is a good time to get started.
I invited Mead, and...
Hey, what are you, poaching all my guys here?
Mead,
my U-tards?
Called me a Mexican. And so I was burned by Mead in my own Discord server today. So I'm sad.
Well,
but
Mead's in your Discord server, so that's something.
Yeah, so there's that.
Mead's not in ours anymore. He left, I think.
I just called to say
I love you. Oh, yeah.
I hope you know that. I love you. Also,
I'm a faggot, I know.
Squigs.
Oh.
We need to talk. The rest of you, I love you. So much.
Did you just take like a bunch of ecstasy or something? I mean, thank you for that nice message and all.
Hey, so you mentioned Baja glass flavors. I know they have a passion fruit out already. I was wondering if you tried that one.
No, I hate passion fruit.
Not, I can send you some.
No!
Other deep Mountain Dew flavors. Have you tried the thrashed apple?
Yes.
Or the fruitcake?
Lord Douche loves the fruitcake one. Was it this past Christmas they did the fruitcake Mountain Dew, or was it last year? Whichever Christmas it was, like afterwards, maybe like towards the spring, we just happened to be at one of those like shitty bargain outlet stores, and they had tons of that Mountain Dew fruitcake that they were trying to get rid of. It was like $1.99 or something for a 12-pack, so we bought like 4 or 5 of them. I personally didn't care for it, but again, Lord Douche loved it.
That's a new one. Let me know so I know whether or not to send those your way so they no longer just... take up space on my shelf.
No, well.
And 7-Up. God, cranberry? I don't know, some sort of other festive stuff. Shit. I gotta stop buying things at Christmas because they're new.
Well, thank you for the offer. I think I have tried all of them, though. So you save that shipping money. You don't have to send anything to me.
Hey, Timmy Boo. So I ass-fucked this bitch for the first time.
Nice.
Tonight, and the lube she had contained benzocaine. And all I could...
Is that like a numbing agent?
...think about while I was realizing that I didn't need to go to the ER was, who was that dude that fucking jerked it with Orajel? Because I basically just Orajel'd my dick.
Yeah, Are you sure that was lube?
Thank you.
Yeah, so that was, what was his name? Window Licker. And last I knew, I was friends with him on Facebook, and it was not doing well upstairs in the old noggin. I think he's like, I don't know. Look, he just wasn't doing well. He thought he was Jesus or something. I don't know. You know, like a lot of my listeners, they lose it at some point. I hope he's doing better now. But yeah, okay. Next.
Hi, Timmy Boo. It's Kuras from Austria. It's now January 1st, 1970, and I think you should get to my voicemail very soon.
Oh, shit.
I love you. Bye.
I'm way behind on these things. Sorry about that. All right. Very good. Thank you very much for all the calls. Keep them coming. It's all the time we have on this edition of the show. I want you guys to email me, show@distortedview.com. Distortedview.com is our official website. voicemail line for you. 206-666-4463. That's 206-660-GOD. Is it OGOD?
The 8 p.m. pervert right on fucking time.
Spread the distortion, STD. Tell all your friends about the show. Don't forget to give us a 5-star rating, a thumbs up, or like wherever you can rate and review podcasts. Now's a great time to sign up for the Sideshow. Why, you ask? Because tomorrow's episode is going to be exclusive, and I'll be back on Monday doing another Sideshow podcast. If you're not members, the next time I'll talk to you will be on Tuesday, so be on the lookout for that. Until then, have a great weekend. Bye, everybody!
Diabetes testing supplies.
This has been another excellent podcast from the Scribe Media Group. Learn more at scribe.net.